Oh my god, what the f***?
Hey guys, it's Sharon.
I realized I look a little bit like gothic and dark today, and it's because of this special occasion, honestly. It's not, but I'm just gonna say it is. So today's obviously text frame, but today's a very special text frame. We're gonna be doing Look What You Made Me Do by Taylor Swift. And if you've heard that song, or heard of it, or seen anything about that song, you know it's a very, very vindictive song. The lyrics are very, a little bit salty. It's a salty song. It's a very look what you made me do type of song. So, oh man. I'm a little bit nervous about this text prank. I will say that right off the bat. Because this person I'm gonna do it on, they don't know it's me. They don't have my number saved. I've never texted them. I've never reached out to them. So you're probably wondering, well, how is that possible? This is one of my teachers. This is an old teacher of mine, and I've noticed it's a common thing. Like, this is my second year of college, and I've noticed that most teachers just have now started to give out their phone numbers for emergencies or whatever. So let's just put it this way. This teacher was very, I didn't hate them. I didn't have anything against them, but I didn't like them that much. I'm a little bit petty. We know I can get a little bit petty. So this teacher basically said, I'm going nowhere with my YouTube career. Like, it's just a waste of time. There's no point. It's not a real job. It's not a real career. It's basically just a road to nowhere. And I was a little bit offended because, first of all, I think YouTube is the future, 100%. So let's just put it that way. I think social media influencers are the future and are getting their foot in the doors for real careers. But let's just leave it at that. So normally, like, it's not the first time I've heard that. It's whatever. I hear it a lot, actually. But you know what? For some reason, that just made me salty because you're a teacher. You're not supposed to say that to any student. Like, you can think it, but don't say it to them. Like, don't tell a student that whatever they're doing is just a waste of time. That's pathetic. So that's why this teacher is going to be the one I'm texting. So if you guys do want to see more text pranks, I definitely suggest you give this a thumbs up and comment down what text prank you want to see next. I also suggest you subscribe for more text pranks. And I will be giving you a little teaser. My next video is going to be another text prank, and it's going to be to Zayn's new song with Sia, Dusk Till Dawn. So definitely make sure you're around for that. I also suggest you follow my social media, including my Twitter and my Instagram, because I'm always asking you guys what videos you want to see, and you guys voted for this video. So this video is for you guys. I feel a lot better about this text prank because they don't know who I am. They don't know it's me. So this could either go horribly well or horribly horrible. There's no in between. But enough of that. Let's get right into this. I am gonna say this right off the bat. I have to cut the chorus because the chorus is literally Taylor Swift repeating, look what you made me do 107 times. Not even 107, but that's what it feels like. So I'm only gonna say that once. Like, I'm always gonna say, look what you made me do once. I'm also gonna have to edit the audio for the lyrics of the song because Taylor Swift is queen of copyright, which is why I did not do a reaction to this song and why I didn't do this text prank earlier. So hopefully we don't get copyright, Taylor. Whatever, let's just get into this.
So I realized as I tried to record the actual text, the program wasn't working, so I'm gonna have to use screenshots for this until I can figure out how to fix it. I also wanna point out I did have to crop the top of it because I don't have his number saved, so obviously I don't want people texting him either. And actually, turns out I can't even use the audio because of copyright, so enjoy this one with just some instrumental, guys. I am so sorry, but I told y'all, she's the copyright queen. Who is this?
Okay, this was an expected response, so, okay.
Sorry, but I think you've got the wrong number.
Also an expected response, you've got the wrong number. You thought. He's not responding. It's been a couple of minutes. Like, I think I'm just gonna send the next line because he has been responding at a fairly normal pace. So I think at this rate, he's just kind of like avoiding me because he thinks it's the wrong number. So I'm just gonna send the next line.
I'm sorry, but I don't own a gun. So you definitely have the wrong number.
I don't own a gun. So you've really got the wrong person. That is so funny. I wouldn't put him as the gun owning type. He's like a little on the younger side. So he's more like a liberal. So I'm not surprised he doesn't own a gun because like every Floridian over the age of like 40 or maybe, yeah, 40, 35, something like that, owns a gun because it's Florida. But anyways. Okay, he's not responding again, and I'm assuming because he still thinks it's the wrong person, like I'm texting the wrong number, so I'm just gonna send the next line.
Please stop texting me. You've got the wrong number.
Please stop texting me. This is what I was saying. Like, this could either go horribly well or horribly wrong. And, like, I hate him. I don't hate him, but I hate him. I'm just gonna keep going. I have nothing to lose at this rate because I have no one else to text. I already texted my ex-bully, and this is a vindictive song. Who am I gonna do it again? My ex-bully again? Like, whatever. This is gonna work. Hopefully.
Is this Susan? We dated years ago, please.
Oh my god, what the f***? I'm not Susan. I feel like I just jinxed the whole situation. This is crazy. Okay, so you said, is this Susan? We dated years ago, please. Dot, dot, dot. That's a lot of dot. Okay, the only Susan I know is my great aunt. And my great aunt is in her 40s, so if she dated this man, she a cougar, which I really don't think she dated this man. But still, this just got interesting.
Made you do what? Kingdom Keys? Since when did you get poetic?
Oh my god, okay, I think he really thinks I'm this Susan chick now. Because he said, since when do you get poetic? So apparently, whoever this Susan was that he dated years ago was not poetic. And I'm assuming things didn't end well between him and Susan because it's not like he's like, oh my god, Susan, how have you been? It's more like, oh, it's you. I really can't stop now. He's taking too long. I'm getting impatient. I need to know what Susan did.
You were the one that cheated.
Oh. What? No way. Susan, how could you? I feel so bad that I'm smiling, but this is crazy because I was not expecting this to happen at all. Apparently, Susan cheated on him. What the hell is going on? This is my favorite text prank, and to think I almost wasn't gonna do this one. This is my favorite one so far. But okay, oh, crap. Oh, I'm like, I'm almost disappointed because like, this is not how I pictured this text prank to go at all, but this is kind of juicy. But then is it bad to post this because he doesn't know it's me and you guys don't know who it is? And it's not like he'll ever come across. I'll decide this at the end of the text prank. Yeah, we'll do that later.
You should move along with it and please stop texting me. I have a family of my own that I am very happy with.
Oh my god. This is so weird because I know nothing about this situation and he thinks I am the one that caused the situation. He basically just said like, leave me alone, I'm happy with my family, which is like, intense. If they did it years ago and he still feels this way, that makes me wonder, what has Susan been doing? Like, does Susan constantly hit him up and is like, it's me again, let me bring you a karma, look what you made me do. Like, oh my god. I can't even say I feel bad because I feel awkward. Like, this is weird. This is not what I thought was gonna happen at all. I was not expecting any of this. This is just weird. Thumbs up if you think this is weird too. Comment down hashtag weird. That's today's comment. And look at me being so unique and saying weird is the comment for today. Whatever.
Sweet mother of God, Susan, please, what will it take for you to leave me alone?
Oh my God. He literally said, sweet mother of God, Susan, please. What's it gonna take for you to leave me alone?
What did this Susan do?
Okay, but also like, I can't even lie, in the back of my head, I'm like, why did my teacher date someone named Susan? Cause he's like a fairly young guy. He's like in his late 20s. And Susan is such like a mom name. Is anyone out there named Susan? I'm sorry, but you have a mom name. But it's okay cause I have a mom name too. Sharon is a mom name.
I'm very intrigued by this story. Oh my god.
This is not what I expected at all. Like, I'm not gonna lie. In my head, I thought he was gonna be like, is this one of my students? Stop texting me or you'll get a grade deduction. What did Susan do? She cheated on him? It seems like she stomped all over this heart, won't stop hitting him up. Like, jeez.
What? All right, have a good one. I'll be waiting for this karma then. Please don't text me again.
Oh my god. it's funny because this text literally sounds like him. 100%, this is something he would say. This is him summarized as a person completely. It says, have a good one. I'll be waiting for karma then. Don't talk to me. Okay, the song starts repeating. So obviously we all know I stopped texting when the song starts repeating because then everyone is like, what are you doing? And also, I'm mainly gonna stop texting because I don't know what to do. I don't wanna keep pushing his buttons because he keeps saying, don't talk to me again. It sounds like there's a lot of issues with this chick. And I don't, this is bad territory because if I keep texting, what if he contacts this Susan chick? What if he contacts authorities like to get some like restraining order or something? Like, I don't know. I don't think, well, he's not gonna contact Susan if he thinks it's me. But then what if like the real Susan gets in contact with him? Okay, yeah, we're not gonna text back. Normally what I do after every text prank is, well, first of all, people know it's me. This is the first time I've done a text prank where the person doesn't know it's me. So with that being said, what I typically do for a text prank is I'll tell the person at the end it's a text prank and then I'll ask them, can I post this? I can't necessarily tell this dude, hey, this is a text prank. I'm one of your former students. Can I post this on my YouTube channel for all my viewers to see? Cause that's just weird. So I'm just gonna leave it as it is. I'm gonna take the L for Susan. I'm gonna leave him alone cause I cheated on him or whatever. Literally what just happened? This was, what the f-? I don't even know what to like think. Well, this was definitely not what I expected at all. Like, it's funny because I was already planning it in my head. I was like, this dude's just probably gonna be like, this is one of my students, literally just stop texting me or like block my number or something. But instead he thinks I'm this woman from his past, which turns out to be very juicy for you guys because I thought this was gonna suck. I thought this one was gonna bite. But what just happened? What the hell just happened? Oh my god, it's so funny because when he was my teacher, I know he was dating this woman and I know it wasn't this Susan chick because he was very happy with her, at least from like what he told the class or whatever, and I'm pretty sure she's the one he ended up marrying. So, I mean, he was my teacher literally like last year. Would I say professor then? I don't care. I still call him teachers. And it's not like people are gonna search texting my professor. People are gonna search texting my teacher. So anyways, teacher, teaching me anyways. Professors teach too, whatever. So it's not like this is like old territory. It is old territory, but it's also fresh territory. This is weird. What did I just do? Look what you made me do, guys. Hey, LOAO. Anyways, if you guys enjoyed this video, definitely give this a thumbs up. Comment down what text you want to see next. Zane is next, so definitely be on the lookout for that. And I will be finishing up Hispanic Heritage Month and getting right into spooky time. Oh my god, this is the time when I come alive. There's gonna be so many Halloween-related videos, guys. I'm so ready. I'm so excited. Anyways, I'm just so weirded out. I can't even finish this outro normally. I'm just, what are the odds of these things happening? Okay, whatever. If you guys want to see more text pranks, probably won't be texting another teacher anytime soon, but definitely subscribe for more. With all that being said, I will see you guys next time. Bye. So pardon my manners, just something about you turns me to a savage.